work on my studio as such. A few modifications, a few ideas I wanted to sort of do. I'll sort of show you around, but basically this is the big difference. It's a bit brighter. I'll show you what I've done. On the corners of the table, I had some holes drilled in the corner of both the legs, and I had these poles stuck into the holes on the front two quarters, and then I had these soft boxes on the top of the poles up high, and they always seemed to be a bit in the way. They didn't sort of get in the way of the video, but I felt that they were in the way of the light above. And the light above is something I made myself. It's a long panel with LED strips in, and you can just about make out there's a halogen floodlight there, and there's another one at the end. Those are the two new additions. I'll turn off the main light in a minute. And hopefully you can see what I've done. Now, to put the light on the ceiling, there's strips of wood which are attached to the beams, and then on there there's some eyelets with some wires hanging down to support the light. The floodlights, I've done some drop brackets. I'll do a close-up of it in a moment. And then there's a horizontal beam going across with the two lights screwed to them. The drop brackets and the halogen light support are not fixed to the light itself. They're from the top supports. Let's get you up a bit higher so you can see what I've done. Hopefully you can now see the original baton going across with the screw eyes and the wire drops, and then screwed to the battens, there's these drop beam battens, and then along the bottom is a strip of wood, and then the light itself has got the quick connect for camera tripods. And the reason I did that was because I want to be able to use these lights for other reasons. Mainly when I do the green meanie run out in the garden, I want some basic lighting. So those, I'll show you. I've added sockets on the back of the lights. I'm going to unplug the light, unclip the light. And now I can get the light and attach it to a tripod. Plug in the appropriate length of cable, and I'm ready to go. So that's the main thing I've done with the lighting, and this is all brought about because I've done a bit of shifting around that control panel. It's got two variacs plus a couple of large transformers in it, and it's getting a bit on the heavy side. Originally I had a shelf along that side which was not really meant for putting heavy loads on it, so I built a shelf frame. It's just these knocked together frames you can get from some of these home stores, and I've actually riveted it together so it didn't fall apart. Normally they're just knocked together and you can dismantle them later on, but I thought, well, I'm going to keep these for a while, so I'll rivet them together so they don't come apart when you move them about. And I made a stronger frame. If you look at one of my previous videos with the rotary spark gap that I've put up recently, you'll see the original frame that I did for that, and that's what brought on the idea of making another one just for the control panel to sit on. So I removed the original shelf. And then while I was at it, I thought I'd do the lighting upgrade as well. Now, one cool thing that I can do is I can turn on my control panel. And if you remember going back onto another video where I showed the dimmer, I've now got it installed. And I've got control of the lights. So there you go, that's the modification so far. I've still got things to do, so the things are in a mess at the moment. But that's the upgrade so far, and possibly more to come.